Good afternoon, everyone. So for the purpose of this assignment, which is instructional video assignment, I will be talking about a lesson plan I created. So here we go. So this lesson plan is basically meant for freshman students right here, junior or freshman students. And the topic would be Art 101, Abstract Art. So here, the goal is in this lesson plan is to engage students in a web-based exploration of abstract art. They're going to be researching favorite abstract painting and the artist behind it using various online resources. The students will visit websites like the Artling, Joy Museum. So this is the Artling. This is the Joy of Museums virtual tours. Then we have the Art Institute of Chicago. And we will look at YouTube videos. And lastly, we will use Flipgrid to present the information that we learn as a student. So the objective of this specific lesson plan would be to have students learn about abstract art, explore famous artists in the genre of abstract art, and then involve themselves or learn more about the artists' lives and engage in a dialogue with, you know, their classmates using interactive technology. So first, on the first day, these students would be going to the Artling website, which is this one. And the students will explore the website and they will browse the page and select a captivating artwork and note the artist's name for further research in part four. So for me personally, this piece of art catches my attention. It always reminds me of Burger King or Taco Bell back in the 80s. So then I want to go to the Joy of Museum virtual tours. I actually looked up this person, which is Kandinsky, but it's not going to take you there originally. So the student, because I want them to get familiar with the website, they're just going to look around, see what virtual museums are available. They have different ones here. Let's go to London, for example, if we want to get creative. And then they'll join different virtual museums and look at different areas. So British Library, for example. And then it takes you to different highlights and so forth. But for this purpose specifically, I want the students to look up abstract art. So abstract art. I'm obviously spelling it incorrectly, but hey, thank God for autocorrect. So then here it gives me some information. And look, I just found something Kandinsky. Pretty sure it's the same artist or even the other painting. But as a student, we want them to join this website. They've chosen a specific topic, which is abstract art. Now students will focus on the art section and search for additional artwork by that artist, which is this one, right? And it's going to show me different things. Look, we know that these two are the same person. Vasily. And I want to see what do they offer? What kind of art do they have from this person? This is definitely not the artist. But let's see. 10 amazing facts. Oh, wow. Some of his quotes. Music is the ultimate teacher. Is that true? So I'm sure that here I'm going to see more videos. So after they have done so, they have looked into this website. I want them to go to the Art Institute of Chicago. So here, this is where I want students to navigate the website. Then using the search function, they will find the artist that they're researching and explore their lifetime work displayed in a single page. So for this guy, I'm going to. What is this guy's name? Blodisky? Kavinsky? Let me see. There you go. Control copy. Let's let it load. Let it load. Let it load. So here we are. We have his, their name, their first, when they were born, when they died, different artworks. If you notice, they all look very similar. Then it's up to the student to really look at what similarities all of their art has. Some of their highlights. Currently, there's no information on any exhibits. And then there's articles. Resources. Perfect. So then, lastly, well, not lastly, but next, once they have this information down, the student is getting information that really catches their attention. They're gonna go to YouTube. Let's just say that, they go to YouTube by using one of the sites here. They click any site. They learn more about the student. And, we want to encourage students to at least watch two videos about that artist to gain a deeper understanding of the artist, influence, and accomplishments. But lastly, which is the interactive portion, keep in mind that this entire time they have been working by themselves. They would go to Flipgrid. You, as a teacher, would have to create a group and have them join a code so that they can submit all of their conversations into one group. As a student, will take about a month or, I mean, a minute or two, like this little girl here. And talking about what they have learned about abstract art and a specific artist that caught their attention. This is a great opportunity to talk to other students as a student, and you'll also respond to other students by, making, I guess, connecting ideas as far as, background of an artist, what kind of art did they really paint, what was the focus in their colors or their mediums. And then from that, it's really gonna. Oh, and also the cool part about Flipgrid is just that, aside from being engaging with other students, it gives an opportunity for students who probably don't feel as comfortable talking, in the front of everyone. They are able to express themselves at the comfort of their home, their own space. And so that way, we all know that all students are actually learning, and it also creates a very inclusive space for all students who, might need more time reading something and submitting this at their own time. So in all, just to say that this web-based plan provided the students with an opportunity to explore abstract art, delve into the lives of the famous abstract artists, and engage in interactive discussions. By utilizing these various online resources, students gain a deeper understanding of abstract and connect with peers in a meaningful way, and encourage creativity and critical thinking throughout the process. We have to remember to adapt to our own styles and presentation preferences, and by using these specific websites or anything similar, by creating these visuals, we hope that students do gather that information needed to submit that assignment on Flipgrid. So that's just a little lesson plan. I hope that we were able to follow along and that all the links were very helpful for each one of you guys.